What's up, my peeps? Welcome back to Toys and James. As usual, I'm Toys, and these are James. Wait a second, that's not right. I'm not Toys. I'm James, so these must be Toys. I got another big old entire wave of Fortnite figs. This time it's the Jazwares, all of Wave 1. And we got all kinds of stuff. We got chests, llamas, we got big old build-a-boxes, all kinds of stuff. Everybody's getting sweaty, so let's check them out. Alright, we'll start off with the solo mode packs, and we'll take a look at Drift first. This is a look at his box, nice purple box, nice artwork of him up top. Bring him in, nice. Look at the back, we have everybody else that's also available, we have all these guys. And some more artwork of him, overlooking everybody, and let's open him up. This is a hard plastic case, so you will need the scissors to open him up. You can't just destroy the packaging, but if you want to just cut along the edges here, probably couldn't even have cut that, but then leave a little bit up top. You can, just peel it out and then still seal it back up if you want. You can save this piece. It's still intact. Save that if you want. And then you have Drift in this other packaging. Let's get them out. You can put the insert back in so then it's still the full display. I'm just going to throw this away, but, you know, if anybody likes to keep the box, there you go. It's a little tip for you. Also comes with this little list. I guess it's like a checklist of everything that's in the wave. So we'll look at all this at the end and see if we have everything. And here we have Drift, looking awesome. I love it when he has a jacket on. Nice. And this is very flexible. You could probably take this off, but because he's got the sleeves attached, I don't know if you'd want to. Comes with the nice hood and the mask on. We'll bend the neck. Nice, this guy's cool. Oh, nice little gold shoes. This guy looks sweet. A legendary skin from Season 5, a Battle Pass skin. You just got this from getting the Battle Pass. And then you had to level him up to get the jacket. I don't think this is full-blown special effects because his eyes are white, but maybe. There's some pink there, but not the whole pink eye, so pink eye, yeah. These are 4-inch figures, I believe, so with that we get a little more articulation. We got a hinge in the shoulder here, and the elbow. Can't do much because the sleeves are big. And a hinge and a swivel in the wrist. The head bends side to side. Oh, it looks like the hood is a separate piece. Are you able to do that? Limited ab swivel. Open it up. Swivel at the waist. That's sort of the thigh, not bad, nice. Double jointed knees. Jacket gets in the way with a lot of the action. Little hinge, little swivel at the foot. And the legs spread out pretty good. There's this loose ass. My bad, I had to pop that peg back in. It came a little loose. Now it's good to go. So, comes with a piece of wood. I guess it's his stand, so we can put him on the stand. Like so. He also comes with the epic Rift Edge pickaxe. Is actually really nice. All this, him in this, part of the Drift set. And let's put it in his hand. Pop it in his hand. And there he is, looking awesome, holding his pickaxe. And we'll leave him posed up just like that. And we'll put him next to his little mini counterpart, the Moose figure. And that's a little baby Drift. Nice. Now we'll take a look at Teknique, another solo mode. She also comes in a purple box, same kind of style, so we'll just get her open. Again, cut along the edge and just leave the top, and you can save the integrity of the package. Ooh, and here we have Teknique chilling. Something to note right away is this hood is detachable, so take her hood down even though I like it. She's really cool. She's like a graffiti artist, so let's look at all the... She got paint all over her clothes, on the hands. Tattoo on the forearm. Oh, paint on her shoesies. But still looking coolsies. She's an epic skin from Season 4. Part of the Aerosol Assassins. This little piece bends. Nice little detail. Obviously, diaphragm swivel. Single joint in the elbow. Full swing. And hinge and swivel in the wrist. Head goes down. Goes back, side to side, kind of all around. Waist, we got some thigh, double jointed knees, hinge and swivel and the foot. Yeah, this is full blown. Yeah, she can kick her own face. Yeah, so this is full on posability in the legs. You can do anything you want, basically. She can sit cross-legged, whatever you're trying to do. And she comes with the Renegade Roller Epic Pickaxe. Nice. We'll put this in her hands, like so. She also comes with a piece of wood, and we'll put her on that. All right, and there she is, posed up on her wood. Put her hood back on. Nice. And there's Teknique, chilling, posed up, looking cool. And we'll put next to her, her little mini counterpart from the Moose Toys. That's Teknique. And next up, we'll take a look at Raptor. He looks surprised for some reason. He's got the nice blue box. Some artwork of him. Same crap on the back. So let's open him up. And here we have a Raptor. Nice. With his yellow ski mask on. His surprised look in the eyes. It's a legendary skin from Season 2. He was at the item shop. 2,000 V-Bucks. This guy looks cool. Oh, he's got some grenades on his belt. Nice detail in the boots. Yellow lace. Got the knee pads on. Nice. Don't affect his bendability. Pouch. Little brown jacket on. Got some bullets chilling. A little tight in the thorax right here. Ah. Right there. Nice little headset on. His head doesn't move that great. You can swivel and move up and down a little bit. The arm is tight, does 360. Swivel and hinge in the wrist. Elbow single with the swivel. Doesn't bend much at all. Got some torso movement right here. Some swivel at the waist. Swivel at the thigh. Double jointed knees. Hinge at the ankle. Swivel right there. And the legs, do whatever you want. He comes with a piece of wood as well, so we'll put him on this, like so. Hey, what's up? He also comes with the rare Spectre pickaxe. That's part of the Stealth Syndicate set. You'd see this with Shadow Ops usually, but this guy's rocking it. So we'll put it in his hand. Alright. That's Raptor all posed up and chilling with his pickaxe. And let's see what he looks like next to his mini-me with a rocket launcher. Nice. Both got the nice yellow heads. Pretty cool. Raptor. And next up, we'll take a look at Carbide. Packaging isn't anything new, so we'll open them up. And here's Carbide, a Season 4 Battle Pass skin. Nice. This is when he's not fully suited up. He doesn't have the mask on. He does have some armor on, though. Nice metallic shine to the armor. I like that. Nice. So let's see what he can do. Oh, there it goes. All right. Up, down, side to side. Single hinge shoulder, 360. Not much at the elbow. The hinge, though, and some swivel. And a hinge and a swivel. And the wrist. Torso moves. Swivel at the waist. Swivel at the thigh. Double jointed knees. And hinge and swivel at the ankle. And all the flexibility you could want with the legs. Comes with the rare Positron pickaxe. And we'll put it in his hands. Whoops. Like so. I'm putting everything in everybody's right hand. I'm right-handed. You can put it in whichever hand you want, you know. And he also comes with a piece of wood. And we'll put him on that. Alright, here he is. Posed up on his little wood. And with him we have a couple of little mini Carbides. We're starting a whole army of Carbides over here, so he definitely looks better with the bigger scale and the cooler looking armor, I think, definitely for sure. And that's Carbide. Next up is someone we haven't seen before, is Bandolier, or Bandoiler. Look at the back, and let's open him up. And here he is, looking nice, the Bandoiler, all done up, got bullets, looking like the Black Rambo, to be honest. Got a headband on, some kind of communication device right here. Camo pants or some kind. Nice. Oh, big old bulky shoes. The bandana on the arm. This guy looks really cool. It's an epic skin from Season 5. He was at the shop for 1,500 V-Bucks. Part of the Tropic Trooper set. He's got a lot of the same posability as all the others. Head. So, I'll move it around a little bit. arm, 360. Bing bang, elbow. Oh, this elbow moves better than the rest. Swivel on the elbow. Hinge and swivel on the wrist. Got some torso. Doesn't do too much. Do get some waist. Legs do everything like you always wanted. Swivel on the thigh. Double jointed knees. Big old bendy knees. Swivel and hinge. And the ankle here. Comes with the epic, what did he beat up Chomp Senior? Because this is Chomp Junior, so I don't know what he's doing with this. But this is from the Chomp set, and this is Chomp Senior's, but we'll put it in his hand, like that. And we'll put him on his piece of wood, like so. And Bandolier's posed up by himself, because there is no Moose figure, so he's just going to chill there by himself. And that's Bandolier. And last up on the solo modes, we have the early game survival kit, Omega. Look at the back. Everybody we already opened, so let's open them up. Here is Omega in his nice armored up suit. Battle Pass skin from Season 4. Looking cool. Like the red on his face. Nice. This guy just looks cool. All black looking cool, I don't know. Some red throughout. Alright, the head. He's got a big old head. All right, here we go. Yeah, moving. Yes. Side to side. Little swivvies. The arm. Ooh, single shoulder. 360. Swivel. Hinge. Wrist is a hinge. And a swivel. Yes. Get some torso movability. Yes. How about that waist? Oh, tight swivel at the waist. Legs do everything. Swivel at the thigh. Double jointed knees, and swivel and hinge at the ankle. Alright. Actually comes with a whole bunch of stuff. So we have the precision back bling, the rare back bling from Season 3 Battle Pass. You got this from Tier 22. This is back bling. We'll put this on him. Oh, he's all back blinged up. Alright, nice. He also comes with a scar, or the Skis Louise, you know I like to say. One of the best ARs in the game. So put this in this hand. Like that. Awesome. He also comes with the epic Onslaught pickaxe. I think you can only get this by beating the Omega challenges. All this part of the Omega set. Well, this and Omega, obviously, part of the Omega set. So, actually, wait a second. I don't want to put this in his hand yet, because he also comes with a glider. The wet paint glider. I guess you just pop this in like this. Like so. Ooh, and very nice, very nice. You have the all kinds of graffiti and stuff. I think this is the first glider the Fortnite figures have had, so this is really cool. I want to pop this in his hand. You can only get this glider if you get a Victory Royale in Season 4. So, you want this glider? You better show me them Vic Roys, alright? So, alright, put him up. And he can have his little umbrella, like he's Mary Poppins. With his gun out. This is cool. Alright. And he comes with some wood. You know he comes with wood. And we'll put him on his wood. And there he is. Oh. And there's Omega, looking like he's floating, with all his gadgets and gadgets, his weaponry, his pickaxe, his back bling. And he's got a glider, so he's got the full regalia. He's all set to go. He looks great. And this is what he looks like with two of his little buddies hanging out. Two other little Omegas. We got the big 4-inch Omega, two little baby Omegas. It's an Omega party. And next we'll open all these chests. There's 6 different ones. I always see these broken into and stolen at Walmart. I don't know if you guys know, but each one has a list of what's in it. So you don't have to, you know, keep opening them, trying to look for whatever you're missing. Because it has the label right on the front. So first we'll open this one with the boogie bag. All this is inside, so let's check it out. And inside we have, ooh, a bunch of, we got 2 pieces of wood, package of stuff, and then the little list that comes and everything. All right, so we'll open this. And just like it promised, we get the boogie bag, the epic back bling. This is for the wingman. If you bought the wingman starter kit for $5, one of those like promotional, you get some V-Bucks and stuff. I like to buy those. Those are pretty cool. So it comes with that. The legendary Skis Louise, legendary Scar, nice. A blue grenade launcher. Maybe that means that this is a rare grenade launcher because it's blue. We get a purple deagle, little purple deagle, or a hand cannon rather. The purple indicating that it is epic, I believe. And we have a gray submachine gun. So this would indicate a common submachine gun. Next, we'll open the standard issue one with all this. All right, let's open it. And just like the other one, we get two pieces of wood, another list, another bag of treats. And no surprises here, just like it says on the front, we get the standard issue back bling from season 4. You got this from getting to tier 11 or 10, I believe. This is part of the Advanced Forces set. Also comes with a green hunting rifle, or uncommon, I guess. A gray AR, normal gray AR, common. A normal gray pistol. And a normal gray burst rifle. Next, we'll look at the chest with the frozen shroud back bling in it. All right, let's open it up. And no surprises here. We got a bag of goods and two pieces of woods and it's a list. And here we have the frozen shroud, the back bling for Ragnarok. This is a legendary back bling. Really long cape, very nice. Like the bone look up top. It's a really nice cape. Ooh, we got a green pump shoddy. I think that means uncommon. Nice. We get two purple dual pistols. I guess that makes them epic. And then we have a blue light machine gun. So a rare light machine gun. This gun looks nice. Alright, halfway through the chest, moving right along. We'll take a look at the one with rust bucket in it. Big reveal, we get the woods and the goods and the list that no one cares about. Alright, we get the rust bucket. Very nice. This was a epic back bling. You got, I think it was free between April 12th and 18th from the shop. This was for like the servers being down or something. Like it was like a gift. This was a season 3 back bling. It's part of the Storm Scavenger set. Very nice colors. Very bright. Looks cool. And then we get a blue scoped assault rifle. Very nice. We get a green Tommy gun or drum gun. A gold or legendary thermal scoped assault rifle. And a blue tactical SMG. And then we'll take a look at Uplink. Or, well, the chest with Uplink in it. And the woods, the goods, and the list. And here we have Uplink, a Season 5 epic back bling, part of the Advanced Forces set. Probably Sledgehammer or somebody would wear this. Nice looking little bedroll right here. They can take a nap when things get too crazy. A bunch of little pockets is actually pretty cool. We also get a heavy shoddy, purple, indicating that it is the epic. And ooh, look at this, yes. Hasta la vista. Nice. The legendary minigun. Nice. This gun's awesome. Look at this. And lastly, we have a nice blue burst assault rifle. We'll take a look at our last chest, the one with catalyst in it, and let's open it up. And per the usual, we get the list, the goodies, and the woodies. And here we have Catalyst, the epic back bling, just like the boogie bag. This was part of a starter kit that you got from the shop for $5. This was part of the Rogue Agent set, and you got this when you got the Rogue Agent from the shop. Also comes with a blue semi-auto sniper, a purple FAMAS or burst assault rifle, a big blue rocket launcher, and a green revolver. And with the chests out of the way, we'll take a look at the Llama Drama Loot Pinata. There's 23 pieces inside, sounds like a lot of stuff, so let's loot this llama. And it's okay, buddy, it's okay. I'm only gonna loot your innards. You don't have to be scared, it's okay. Now, you're welcome to loot your llama any way you want, but I want to keep the llama intact so I can display it. So what you want to do is cut this plastic up top, so you can remove this. And now this is exposed down bottom. on the bottom here, once you have these frillies out of the way, you can see where the box opens. So take your little cutter and just gently give it a slice. Just pop this tab here, get the little sides open here. Fold open your flaps. And then according to my calculations, it should be a raining, oh man, llama loot all over the place. Who's gonna clean this mess up? I removed all the confetti, and I'll open up all these so then we can just blow through them. Alright, there was a lot of things in there. 23 things to be exact, and first we'll take a look at the Cuddle Bow. A legendary Season 3 back bling that you would see on the Cuddle Team Leader, probably. This is part of the Royal Heart set. Nice little bow. We get the Bright Bag, the epic back bling that you would see with the Bright Gunner or the Bright Bomber. Also a Season 3 back bling, part of the Sunshine and Rainbow set. We get the Scaly back bling, another legendary Season 3 back bling. You would see this with Rex. And lastly, we have Satchel, a legendary back bling from Season 2. You got this when you bought Raptor. Nice little shovel, little canteen of water, and your little to-go bag is complete. We also get a purple scar, epic scar, a purple light machine gun, very nice, a green silent SMG, a blue assault rifle, a blue Tommy gun, or a drum gun, a nice blue pump, a legendary burst assault rifle, a legendary grenade launcher, a legendary sniper rifle, and a legendary rocket launcher. Very nice. The llama comes with one figure, the epic Rusty Lord, the Rust Lord, from Season 3, part of the Storm Scavenger set. And this was a Battle Pass skin. Nice metal-plated helmet here. It's got a nice blue scarf on, with a nice brown jacket. And some of the battle-ready pants. And this guy does look like Star-Lord. Now let's take a look at how he moves. Let's see, not too much in the head. We get some side-to-side. Single hinge all the way around. Elbow isn't the best. You get some swivel. And in the wrist, same thing, hinge and swivel. Some torso. Waist swivel. Swivel in the thigh. Double-jointed knees. And a pivot and swivel in the foot. And total freedom in the legs. And that's Rust Lord. Poor guy doesn't have a stand. And here's what he looks like next to his little Rust Lord. Couple of rusty lords just hanging out. And that's Rust Lord. And this time around we get some brick, which is nice. But this is no ordinary brick. This brick has a picture on it. So it's almost like a puzzle. So let's put it together. Just snap the pieces in place. And just line them up. And there we have a nice, good game spray paint. And it comes with some more brick with another picture on it. And just like the last one, we'll put the pieces together. Nice. Snap them in. And complete your wall. And the completed picture is a nice drift spray paint. Very cool. And if you want, you can connect these walls to have one big spray painted wall. Next, we'll take a look at this big old squad mode pack. We got Rex, Cuddle Team Leader, Bright Bomber, Ragnarok, a bunch of guns, some pickaxes, some wood. 17 pieces all together. A quick look at the back just to show you some of the artwork. Let's open it up. And we'll start things off with Rex, a legendary Season 3 skin, part of the Dino Guard set. And he's looking cool in his nice dinosaur combat outfit. And just like a big Scooby-Doo reveal, we'll pull the mask off and reveal it as Jonesy the whole time. Little Jonesy. Put the mask back on. He looks really nice with his bright green outfit and his orange scarf. This guy was at the shop for 2,000 V-Bucks, and he looks pretty cool. He has pretty much all the same articulation as the others. The head with the mask on might need a little adjusting, but I can still do the most I can. Hinge in the shoulder, get your 360. Hinge and swivel in the elbow. Hinge and swivel in the wrist. A little bit of torso, some waist, thigh swivel, double jointed knees, and hinge and swivel in the foot. And of course the legs do everything. He also comes with a piece of wood, so we'll put him on that, like so. He comes with the Party Animal Pickaxe, one of my favorite pickaxes ever. Got the big old slurp on top, and it's like a big old keg. And when you swing it, sloshes, just sloshes around. An epic pickaxe from Season 4. This is really cool. So we'll put this in his hand, and we'll put this in his left hand this time. Like so. And he also comes with a purple scoped assault rifle that we'll put in his other hand. Like that. Nirex is posed up looking cool with his guns and his pickaxe. So you can obviously mix and match the guns and the pickaxe, but I'm just going with what was next to him in the packaging. And here he is next to his little baby Dino Rex. And they're just a happy little dinosaur family. And that's Rex. And next up, we'll look at this pink, cute, cuddly, teddy bear looking girl. The Cuddle Team Leader. A legendary skin from Season 3. Part of the Royal Heart set. At the store for 2,000 V-Bucks. She looks really nice in her nice, bright, pink, fuzzy outfit. A nice, fuzzy bum. And if this was my team leader, I'd definitely cuddle with her. Some of the articulation you get in the neck, you obviously get a nice exposed neck, so it's better range of head movement and side to side. Same thing with the shoulders, though. You get a hinge, 360, elbow, swivel, hinge. Wrist is hinge and swivel as well. A little bit of torso action. Some waist swivel. Some tight thigh swivel. Double jointed knees, and a nice hinge and swivel in the foot, and full freedom in the legs. And we'll put her on her piece of wood that she comes with, like that. She also comes with the nice winged and hearted, lovely tat axe. This is a rare harvesting tool, and we'll put it in her hand, like so. She also comes with the gold or legendary dual pistols. So we'll take the axe back out of her hand so we can put these pistols in. There she is posed up with her dual pistols in her hand, looking nice. Now you gotta ask yourself, do you feel lucky, punk? And that is the pink and cuddly Cuddle Team Leader. And there she is, Mama Bear and Baby Bear, just hanging out together. Cuddle Team Leader. Next up is the rare Season 3 skin, the Bright Bomber. Nice. Looking really cool in her nice, bright, pink, colorful outfit. Got her red hair, don't care, nice little sunglasses up top. I really like this Under Armour or whatever she has throughout here. We'll check out her articulation. We got the head up, down, very little, side to side. Shoulder hinge, 360, elbow hinge and swivel, and wrist hinge and swivel. Torso moves around a little bit. Little bit at the waist swivel, little thigh swivel, double jointed knees, and hinge and swivel in the foot. And the legs are great. She also comes with wood, so we'll pop her on her stand, like this. She comes with her classic epic rainbow smash pickaxe. Very nice llama head up top. And we'll put this in her hands, like so. She also comes with a epic semi-auto sniper. And we'll put this in her other hand, like that. And here's Bright Bomber posed up with her sniper rifle and her pickaxe, ready to snipe and ready to farm some materials. And there she is with her little baby Bright Bomber, two unicorn smash pickaxes. I'm seeing double, and that is the Bright Bomber. And the last figure in the pack is the awesome-looking Ragnarok. This guy looks great. A legendary Battle Pass skin from Season 5, all the way from Tier 100, and this guy looks awesome. Look at this face. Nice beard, see-through, like clear beard. Nice skin. Demonic skull head. These armor pieces are like maneuverable and like can move. His nice little skirt flaps or whatever. He's got a nice horn attached to his belt. This guy is awesome. Some big bulky armor pieces here. And this guy looks great. Now this guy's articulation is a little different than the rest. He almost has no head because of this big nice beard in the way. You can go a little side to side. You can get a little bit, a little side to side. As well with the shoulders, these armor pieces kind of slide up and out of the way. But just be careful of those. But you'll get 360 and hinge in the shoulder. Hinge and swivel in the elbow. Hinge and swivel in the wrist. Pretty good amount of torso movement for all the bulky armor he has on, to be honest. And some swivel in the waist. Thigh swivel. double jointed knees, but these are probably the least impressive knees we've seen so far, in a hinge and swivel in the foot. We'll put him on his stand so he can stand up almighty looking. Oh wow, that guy looks great. He comes with the awesome looking permafrost pickaxe, the epic pickaxe, all part of the Harbinger set, him and Ragnarok. I just really like the how they got the blue, like the see-through, to look at like that smoky ice look, just like his beard. So we'll put this in his hand, like that. This guy's a badass. He also comes with the legendary gold heavy shotgun. And we'll put this in his other hand. And there's Ragnarok posed up, looking great. Probably my favorite looking figure so far. He just looks like such a badass. I love it. And here he is, next to little baby badass Ragnarok. Both of them looking great. But the bigger of the two, obviously outshining, Ragnarok. And the last thing I have for you today is the big old bulky turbo building set. We get Raven, we get Jonesy. Quick look at the back just to show you the art. And you can actually build a bunch of things with this, it says. And right here, show us what you got. Nice. And they're in a crazy build battle. Let's check them out. All right, out of the box, we got a whole crap ton of materials. Big old pile of wood. And finally, nice to see a big old pile of brick and some metal. So we can finally start building. This piece is actually already comes put together, so you can just leave that like that. So I'm over here with Max Mats all of a sudden. So with the materials out of the way, let's check out the figures. First, we'll take a look at Raven, a legendary skin from Season 3. This guy is really nice. He's kind of got a sunken in face with just two eyes on it. Like, I know he has like a dark cloaked hood anyway, but like it would have been... I don't know, his face just sunken in, I don't know. So take a look at this guy in his all black and purple outfit, looking really nice. Part of the Nevermore set. Is at the shop for 2,000 V-Bucks. This jacket comes down here, nice. His nice frilly little feathers here. This guy looks half Raven, half Dark Shadow, half Nightmare, equaling all terrifying, fantastic. Take a look at some of the articulation. There is nothing in the head besides side to side. There is no front and back, just side to side. He's got a big old bulky hooded head. We get a hinge and 360 in the shoulder, hinge and swivel in the elbow, and hinge and swivel in the wrist. Some good torso movement, waist swivel, thigh swivel, double jointed knees, his little jacket kind of gets in the way, and hinge and swivel in the foot. And full range in the legs, minus what the little jacket's gonna block you from. He comes with the epic AC/DC pickaxe, Season 2 exclusive pickaxe from the Battle Pass when you got to tier 63, I believe. This one's really cool. It's like two little Tesla coils. It's gonna do a little lightning rodding. You're gonna get some nice effects. And we'll put this in his hand, like that. He also comes with the blue silent SMG and the blue revolver. Again, you can put these with whoever you want, but I'm just going with what they were next to. And we'll put the silent SMG in his hands, like that. And there's the Dark Raven posed up, looking nice and scary. And there he is, looking scary next to his little baby Raven. Just a couple of birds flocking together. That's Raven. Next we'll look at Jonesy, a default skin, probably the most popular default skin, the default skin that started it all. He's rocking, of course, his classic default skin look. His standard issue camo pants and tactical gear, his dog tags hanging out with his little scarf. Take a look at some of the articulation in the head. Goes up and down, side to side, just like everybody else. Hinge in the shoulder, 360. Hinge and swivel in the elbow, hinge and swivel in the wrist, some torso movement, swivel at the waist, swivel at the thigh, double jointed knees, and swivel and hinge and the foot, and full freedom legs. And as you may have guessed, he comes with his classic default pickaxe. So put this in his hands, like that. And he comes with a blue hunting rifle and his classic green tac shotty that we always see him rocking. So we'll definitely put this in his hands, like that. And there's classic Jonesy hanging out by himself, looking like a default skin. And here we have a default skin party, couple of Jonesys hanging out, looking nice. Jonesy. And just like on the box, I'm trying to have Raven and Jonesy posed up on their little build-a-piece, ready to get into a build battle. Alright you guys, so here's everything on the list.
Here's all the people. Bandolier, Bright Bomber, Carbide, Cuddle Team, Drift, Jonesy, Omega, Ragnarok, Raptor, Raven, Rex, Rustlord, and Teknique. As you can see, there they all are. All the weapons lined up in their respective slots. The only thing we don't have is the purple grenade launcher for some reason. I don't know where that is. And then we have an extra legendary gold scar. Other than that, get her legs out of the way. Other than that, this is what all the weapons look like. And then on this side, this is more weapons on this side. All those. All the pickaxes. All the back blings. And the one glider.
So that's the whole list. And I wanted to give you guys a full scale look at just some of the things you can do with all these materials and everything. So here's a lot of action going on. It's a big old endgame fight right here. Alright, let's check out some of the action we got going on over here. We got Carbide right here trying to quick scope. We got Jonesy and Raven going at it. Bandolier is laying on that minigun. We got Drift spray painting himself. Cuddle Team just got done flipping sexy. We got Omega landing on this dude. He's pissed. Ragnarok's shooting launchers. We got Bright Bomber going for peak scopes. We got Rex going for edits and Teknique jumping over him in a shotgun battle. Raptors looting chests. What's going on over here? Alright guys, and this is just a little taste of what you can do with everything. So you can get really creative. Come up with whatever you want to come up with. This is just a couple of things I threw together. Alright you guys, well that's it for me. Thanks for watching. This video is going to be pretty long. It's probably going to take me about a fortnight to upload. But I hope you enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun. And I'll see you guys in the next one.